Hello everyone, let us begin with the next session on backbone networks. So coming to the understanding of what is backbone networks, it is nothing but it is going to consist of more number of or several LANs which are going to get connected. So in this particular backbone network, no station is directly getting connected to the backbone. What does it mean? It means that it is going to have in between one more LAN, and then that LAN gets connected to the backbone LAN network or backbone network. So the stations are a part of a LAN and the backbone connects the LAN. So that is how a backbone network is constructed. Say suppose I take two stations, station A and station B. What is meant by two stations is two PCs or two nodes. So if I take two such kind of nodes, so those two nodes here, they are not going to get connected to that backbone network which is going to be present here. So instead we are going to have in between LAN which will help first station to get connected to that LAN and the second station to get connected to that LAN. From that LAN we will be having a connection being done to the backbone network. So in between this LAN and this backbone network, I can have my devices which we have studied in the previous session. Like I can have a bridge, I can have a repeater, I can have not a repeater, I can have a gateway. So I can make use of a router and a bridge to have the connection being set up between two LANs which are existing here, that is getting connected to the station, and one acting at the backbone of the network. Then the classification of these backbone networks, which can be done as in a two common ways depending upon the different architectures that are available. So we have the very first one, which is a bus backbone network, and one more is star backbone network. So coming for in a bus backbone, the topology of the backbone is in the form of a bus. So we know that whenever we say it as a bus, to that bus I will be having more number of end stations getting connected to that particular bus directly without any intermediate use of the devices, connecting devices. So now let us look at what is that bus that is going to be present here is going to be, or how it behaves. In a bus backbone, the topology of the backbone is in the form of a bus. So this bus backbone normally used as a distribution backbone to connect different buildings in an organization. Say suppose we have three or four departments, EC department, then I have mechanical department, then I have CS department, and then I have civil department. So I am having four different departments now. I want to connect all these four departments to one single backbone network. So how is it possible? So each building can comprise of a single LAN of its own or another backbone of its own. From that each building I will have one line which is getting connected to a common LAN connection, and that LAN connection will be provided to the server. So that common junction where I will have four departments getting connected in the form of a bus to that particular LAN is what is called as bus backbone network. So that's the best example to note. And then coming to the figure which is given here, it is what I said already, like we have LAN 1 of EC department, CS department, mechanical and civil engineering department. So all these LANs are already existing which are serving the purpose of those particular departments. But in between, what we want to do is whatever the communication that we do with the usage of this LAN has to be first transmitted to the connecting device bridge, and from bridge it will be getting connected to one single backbone network which will be further getting connected to our server. So that is how your backbone network is going to work for us. So that's the example. Moving on to, we have another topology as already said. are all, as already mentioned, which is a star backbone topology. So in star backbone topology, the backbone is in the form of a star. The backbone is just going to act as one single switch, means it is going to be a switch to that particular LAN getting connected, means one to one communication will be established, one node to one node, in the same lines one LAN to one backbone network connection. There is no other intended data can be shared among the other LANs which are getting connected, like we have seen in case of our bus. Whereas in bus we saw that all the LANs are getting connected to the bridges, and from the bridges directly getting connected to a single bus. But now here we have a intended single switch for that particular kind of network. So coming for this star backbone, it is sometimes also called as collapsed or switched backbone. The topology of this backbone is a star, and this configuration, in this particular configuration, the backbone is just one switch, as already told. Why it is called as erroneously or collapsed backbone. So I gave the another name for this star backbone as what is collapsed backbone. Collapsed backbone network. So why the name collapse? The name collapse is because if you see in this particular diagram or an example, every single LAN is getting connected to one switch, correct? So I said it is going to get connected to a one switch. So if by chance LAN 1 fails, so there is no more connection which we can establish to that particular LAN from the or with the help of the backbone network which is existing. On the same lines, say suppose there is some issue with the LAN connection in some department. So if that LAN connection fails or that LAN breaks, so there is no more data transmission which will happen from this backbone network through this switch to the LAN. So that is why we say this as a collapsed backbone. So it can collapse at any instant of time. This star backbones are mostly or predominantly used in distribution backbones inside a building, wherein if I have a multi-floor building, how this multi-floor building can help us to serve each one of the LAN connections. So in such cases we are going to install such a kind of star backbone network which is available. And then how do we actually install this is, we often find a rack or a chassis in the basement where the backbone switch and all hubs or switches are installed, and from there the individual LANs are drawn physically in the form of a star topology and installed in a closet on the corresponding floor. So that is how we can make use of this type of star backbone topology. The another common application of the remote backbone network is connecting remote LANs. So what is this connecting remote LANs? Connecting remote LANs refers to, if I am there in one of the LAN network which is existing and it is already connected to the backbone network, I can go access my station again getting connected from a different LAN, but that LAN again is coming back to my original backbone network. So that is one of the predominant or one of the best kind of application or a common application that is majorly used in offices and LANs, and needs to connect those kinds of devices from one building to another building which is connected at the back end. The connection can be done through bridges. Sometimes these bridges are also called as remote bridges. As you can see in this particular figure, I have three LANs, LAN 1, LAN 2 and LAN 3. All these three LANs are getting connected to a bridge, where the bridge is having a point to point kind of line that is established, and from that particular bridge we will have the connection being set up to the end device that is at the backbone network, so which is not visible here as of now, as we are trying to focus on the application of having a LAN network. So once we have such kind of point to point network which is existing between these two these kinds of bridges, especially when we make use of leased telephone lines or ADSL lines, so these lines helps us to provide the connection between point to point devices. So this kind of point to point link, it can make use of point to point protocol, so which is as exactly shown in the particular figure. So that is the major application that we have. So that is how we do in our departments sometime. Like I'll be accessing the system number one in the department, and I move on to the another area where I have, or another department where I have one more system number named as 10. So from this 10 I can definitely access the system number one, which we call it as remote login. So that can be done with the help of such kind of remote LANs connections. So that is the major application that we have in case of remote connectivity. So a point to note, and that is a point to point protocol can be used, that is for a point to point link access a LAN in a remote backbone connected by remote bridges. So that's about the backbone networks, so which gives a brief introduction about the architecture of the backbone network, which defines two kinds of topologies or backbones. One is bus backbone and one more is star backbone, and then we have the application of it, which is dealt as connecting remote LANs with the usage of the bridges, and that bridges are going to make use of the point to point links and can further make use of point to point protocols. So that's all. Thank you.